We said goodbye to many notable people in 2016. Each of the people we remember today, as well as many unnamed others, left their mark on the world. And although they're gone, their legacy continues. Among the amazing people we are eulogizing today, some of them were not just remarkable, they broke barriers. On November 7th, Janet Reno passed away. First woman to serve as Attorney General of the United States, Reno's nearly 8 years in that position makes her the second longest serving Attorney General in United States history. Born and raised in Florida, she left the state to go to Cornell for her undergraduate degree, and then on to Harvard Law School, where she was one of only a few women in a class of more than 500. After receiving her Juris Doctor degree, Reno returned home to Florida, where she was bypassed for positions in many of the larger Miami law firms due to her gender. She acquired a position in a small firm in Miami and began to get involved in local politics. This led to her position with the Dade County Attorney's Office, where she won 5 consecutive elections. She was known for her child advocacy work, and it was her legal reputation for precision and her reputation for incredible integrity that led Bill Clinton to appoint her to Attorney General in 1993. After leaving the position in 2001, Reno returned again to Florida, where she spent the rest of her life advocating for children, speaking about criminal justice issues, and working to exonerate wrongly convicted individuals using DNA evidence. Janet Reno died on November 7th in Miami, the place of her birth and the place of much of her life. And then, just a week later, on November 14th, we lost Gwen Ifill. Ifill attended Simmons College in Boston, where she received her degree in communications, and her dedication to impeccable reporting earned her positions at the Washington Post and the New York Times. Ifill spent 10 years working as a newspaper reporter before being recruited by NBC and making the jump to broadcast journalism. Ifill is perhaps best known for her work on PBS NewsHour, where she and her co-host Judy Woodruff broke barriers by being the first all-female anchor team on the network Nightly News. Throughout her career, Ifill was revered for her journalistic integrity. In 2004 and 2008, she moderated the vice presidential debates, and her coverage of the 2008 election earned her a George Foster Peabody Award. More recently, Ifill served as the co-moderator in the Democratic primary debate between Hillary Clinton and Bernie Sanders. Ifill's accomplishments, amazing as they are even more astonishing, considering she did them as a woman of color in a profession largely comprised of white men. She took her role as a barrier breaker seriously. She said, "Every time a young black girl shyly approaches me for an autograph, or writes, or calls, or stops me on the street to ask how she can become a journalist, I feel an enormous responsibility. It's more than simply being a role model. I have to be a voice for them as well." And on Christmas Day, we lost yet another barrier breaker, astronomer and astrophysicist Vera Rubin. Rubin graduated from Vassar in 1948 with a degree in astronomy, and wanting to continue her work at the graduate level, well, she tried to apply to Princeton's astrophysics graduate program. However, they would not even send her a course catalog on the grounds that they did not admit women to their program. So instead, she went to Cornell for her master's degree and then received her PhD from Georgetown University. And it was there that her studies and observations of the properties and motions of galaxies that led her to discover dark matter. And to quote her New York Times obituary, it led to the realization that what astronomers always saw and thought was the universe is just the tip of a lumbering iceberg of mystery. Rubin was awarded the National Medal of Science in 1993 and has served as a guiding light for a generation of female astronomers. And despite the obstacles she faced based on her gender, she seemed to have an attitude of optimism and perseverance. She once said, "Don't let anyone keep you down for a silly reason such as who you are. And don't worry about prizes and fame. The real prize is finding something new out there." A theme among these three extraordinary women is that they were exceptional at what they did. And they had to be. Barrier breakers have to be great at what they do. And they were all exceptional, and I'm grateful for their achievements. They have shaped society through their exemplary work, and they have shaped society because they demanded that they be allowed to do it. They demanded that they be taken seriously. So Vera Rubin, Gwen Ifill, Janet Reno, we take you seriously. And we thank you for your extraordinary work and your extraordinary lives.
Bowie. He is a first.